Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about fault detection location classification by ANFIS. So ANFIS nothing but Adaptive Neuro-Fuzzy Inference System. So ANFIS having the property of neural network and the fuzzy logic system. Okay, so we are combining the property of the neural network with the fuzzy inference system. So that's why it is known as ANFIS. So by using the ANFIS concept, we are going to detect the fault and classify the fault and find the location of fault in the power system. And this is the model we developed for detecting and detection and classification and finding location in the fault in this power system. So this system consists of three buses. So bus 1, bus 2 and bus 3. Bus 1 and bus 2 having source feeder, so the rating is around the 11 kilovolt and then it rated at 30 MVA, and bus 2 also rated at 11 kilovolt and rated at 30 MVA, and bus 1 and 3 is connected via the distribution line having a 10 kilometer length. Okay, so with having separated by the 10 kilometer line, so in between here we have created fault. Okay, so here we can create the fault, different fault like the line to ground fault, double end to ground fault, double end fault, triple end fault, triple end to ground fault. Okay, and then the bus 2 will be connected to this point, and after this we have transformer, right? So it going to be convert that 11 kilovolt to 400 volt, that means so it is a distribution, right? So it's going to be converted into customer voltage level, right, by using this transformer. So converting 11 kilovolt to 400 volt, and then here we are having load. Okay, and here in order to train that ANFIS adaptive neuro-fuzzy inference system, we need to collect the data. So here we are going to collect the data of the bus 1 voltage and current, that means we are going to collect the RMS voltage of the bus 1 and the current, RMS current of the bus 1, and also we are going to collect the 0 seconds voltage of the bus 1 and 0 seconds current of the bus 1. Okay, so this is going to be considered the input data for that ANFIS. Okay, so output will be it have 4 binary number, right? So this binary number going to be designed, going to be, so for that we have to write the program. Okay, so this is a program used to for collecting the input and the fixing the target data. Okay, here we are going to consider case 1. So here we are going to make that the transmission line length equal to 10, and then we are going to collect the data. Okay, so here we are simulating the model for normal case. So for we are created different fault model here, right? For that mean this is the doubling fault, right? AB fault, ABC fault, ABC ground fault, ABG fault, and then AC fault, ACG fault, AG fault, PC fault, PC G fault, and BG fault, and CG fault, right? So we have created different fault as a separate model. So from each model, we are going to collect the data of the bus 1 voltage RMS, the bus 1 current RMS, and then bus 1 0 seconds voltage and bus 1 0 seconds current. Okay, and then here we are going to fix the target data. The first 4 will be used for fixing the target for detection, right? For detection and classification, right? So this 4 bit used for detecting a fault and classify the fault. So for different condition, for normal condition, here we are fixing at that mean the binary bit, which is equal to 0 0 0. Okay, for AG fault, right? So here we are fixed at 1001, and then for PG fault we are fixing the binary value 0101. Okay, and the last value is denoted the location of the fault. Okay, so here we are create the fault at location 10 kilometers. So that's why we are collecting the data. Same way we have to collect the data for the different fault conditions, right? And also here in case 2 I'm going to change the fault location 50 kilometer, and then I am going to collect the data for normal case and different fault case. And case 3 we are fixing the fault at line length of 1 kilometer, and then we are collecting the data, and then so finally it won't be used to for train the model. Okay, so now I'm going to simulate this code, right? So this code going to be collect the data from that normal case as well as fault case. So here you can see that that mean data t and x will be the data collected from the different cases, case 1, case 2, case 3, and then for a normal condition and a fault condition. Okay, so it going to be collect the data for up to case 3, and then after that the system will be trained in the ANFIS. Okay, that means after collected data, right? So the data are going to be used for train the ANFIS network. Okay, so after training we have two fuzzy inference system, so one for a classification and detection, another one for a locate the fault. Okay, so here you can see that, so here we are used to fuzzy Simulink clustering concept for classification. Okay, for classification reduction. Okay, and here we are used grid partition based ANFIS training. Okay, for finding the location. Okay, so after this training, right, here the data will be stored here, right? So this is the final trained ANFIS model, right? So let me open that model in the fuzzy. Okay, first I'm going to open the classify this one. Yeah, so here you can see that it receiving the nearly 8 input, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. The first 3 will be RMS voltage of the first one voltage. This 4 to 6 is known as RMS current of the first one. And then 6, 7 and 8, 9, nothing but that's 0 sequence voltage and current. So the output will be here the binary form, right? So based upon that, we are generating that detail, right? Based upon this input, it will be generated the output. Okay, so here you can see that. So this is the fuzzy rules is created here. So it will be changed, right? If suppose input won't be changed, you can see the variation in the output, right? So this model going to be used for classify and detect the fault in the system. And same way we are having another model, nothing but locate.fis. So I'm going to import from the file. Yeah, it have 3 inputs only. Okay, so here you have to provide the RMS voltage of the bus 1, and then that going to be used for locate the fault. Okay, and here you can see the rules. So these are rules, right? So it won't be vary, right, based upon this voltage, right? So this is going to be used for locate the fault length. Okay, so now I'm going to simulate this model. So here, okay, here I'm here you can see that I created the fault as ABC ground fault. Okay, so I'm going to make A to ground fault. Okay, and then here the length is fixed at 6 km, and then here length is fixed at 4 km. And then here you can see that, so this is a fault detection classification model. So it receiving RMS voltage and current and 0 seconds voltage current from the bus number 1, and then this is fault location finding model, first that means ANFIS system. So it receiving the RMS voltage of the first one, and it would going to provide the location, exact location of the fault. Okay, so this binary going to be convert with the greater than 0.5 to convert to binary form. So this binary going to be given to classification model. So it going to be classify the system based upon this decoding logic, right? So here we are create a decoding logic here. So based upon decoding logic, so it will be detect the fault as well as classify the fault. Okay. So if now I'm going to simulate this model and then check the results. Now you can see that the fault is detected in the system, right? And then you can see that the fault is created is A to ground fault, and A to ground fault also is detected. And then you can see that so the fault location is around 6.42. So here the fault is created at 6 km, right? But we are getting around that we nearer to that 6 km. So the fault detection classification location is more accurate in the ANFIS system. And also I'm going to change the kilometer now. So I'm going to change the kilometer equal to 2, and then here I'm going to make to 8. So because total length will be 10 km, so that's why I changed to 2 8, right? So now I'm going to simulate the model. So here you can see that the fault detection is detected quickly, as well as the fault classified as much quickly. And also we are getting fault location is around 2.43 km. That means we fixed the kilometer, that means the kilometer we fixed here is 2 km, but we are getting around 2.4, so it having the nearer value to the 2 km. So let me change the fault. So I'm going to change the fault to AB ground fault, that means double end ground fault. We will check the results now. So here you can see that fault is detected, and also here you can see that the fault is fully classified as a ABG ground fault. Okay, and then you can see that the fault location is around 2.1 km. Okay, so I'm going to change the fault as ABC fault, okay, tripling fault, and then simulate the model. So here you can see that the fault is detected, and fault is classified as ABC fault. Okay, and then you can see that the fault location is around 1.9, so we fixed it to 2 km, but we are getting around 1.9 km. So next I'm going to change doubling fault and then simulate the model. So we created a BC fault, right? The fault between a line B and C. So here you can see the fault is detected, and fault is classified as a BC fault. Okay, and then we are getting location around 2.015 km. So the fault is occur at 2 km, but we are getting that mean around 2.015 km. okay, so let me change the fault is triple length ground fault, and then simulate the model. We'll check the results. Here you can see that fault is detected, but the fault is not classified, because fault is classified as a ABC fault. Okay, so because ABC ground fault and ABC fault having a similar kind of data, okay, that's why the fault is detected as ABC fault. Okay, but you can see that fault location here, right? Fault location we are getting around 1.927 km. okay, the fixed kilometer, that mean the kilometer is fault occurred the kilometer is 2 km, but here we are getting 1.9 km, right? So mostly is around we have the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, out of 11 fault, right? So 10 fault will be classified in the system. So the accuracy of the system is around 90%, 91%, right? And also the fault location is effectively detected from the ANFIS model, right? So this is working of fault detection location classification by Adaptive Neuro-Fuzzy Inference System. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.